Manuel Pangilinan of the Metro Pacific Group has been named the next chief executive of Manila Electric Company. Alvin El Chico reports.
After 24 years at the helm of the country's biggest power utility, Manuel Lopez steps down as chief executive officer of Meralco beginning July 1. In Tuesday's stockholders' meeting, Lopez relinquishes his position as CEO but will remain as chairman of the board. According to Lopez, it is time to move on and spend more time and serve the Lopez family business, specifically Benpress and Lopez Inc. Lopez has served as Meralco director, president, and CEO since 1986.
I have served this company through six decades. Since 1965, when I joined this company as a management trainee. As your CEO, I could have not asked for more. I am indeed one very lucky chief executive officer. You have given me and this company your trust, support, and loyalty. Your malasakit is a constant inspiration to me. I now ask you to give your full support to the next chief executive officer, Mr. Manuel B. Pangilinan.
PLDT Chairman Manuel Pangilinan takes over as CEO and President of Meralco. Jose Ping de Jesus, who is currently President, will remain as Chief Operating Officer of the firm. Unlike in previous years, Tuesday's stockholders' meeting ran smoothly with all the 11 nominees getting elected to the board. The Pangilinan-Lopez bloc controls more than 40% of the company, represented by board members Pangilinan, Lopez, De Jesus, Napoleon Nazareno, and Ray Espinoza. The San Miguel Corporation bloc, together with its ally shareholders, hold more than 30%, represented by SMC Chair Ramon Ang, Estelito Mendoza, Estelita Go, and El Picuna. Ang remains as Vice Chairman of Meralco.
There are two basic principles. No? I think one is that I'd like to see preserving what's best of Meralco and continuing moving forward, continue those things that that are good for Meralco moving forward, and to change only those things that are needed for its future. No? We'd like to continue working with San Miguel in partnership in improving the welfare of Meralco. No? So I don't see any major change moving forward. And certainly, we'd like to work with the people of Meralco in looking at the new future.
SMC does not intend to sell its 27% stake in a power retailer, as its chair Ramon Ang sees a bright future ahead for energy investments. Aside from electricity distribution, SME is also involved in power generation.
With the incoming government's good reputation, I think a lot of investors will be coming, and it will create more power demands in the coming years. So I think Meralco and the other shareholders will be preparing for this surge in demand.
After a series of price spikes in electricity prices since the first quarter, Pangilinan sees lower power prices in the months ahead.
It looks like the energy, the prices of energy sources, including crude oil, are down for a number of reasons, including what's happening in Europe. We anticipate that generation costs should go down.
Meralco's net income reached 6 billion pesos in 2009, more than double compared to the 2.8 billion peso profit it posted in 2008. Alvin El Chico, ABS-CBN News.